When Jacob Berry finished high school in 2012, his next step was a question mark.
I really was unsure for a couple of years about what I wanted to do.
The 22-year-old later applied to West Virginia Junior College in Bridgeport, where he would major in information technology. During the application process, Jacob informed the admissions office that he had been homeschooled. After being accepted, he began taking classes, earning straight A's.
It went smooth and everything was going great.
Then it all changed. As part of a class assignment, Jacob and other students had to interview the school president, Sharon Stevens. During their meeting, Jacob's education became an issue. He was told his presence on campus jeopardized the college's federal funding. Stevens gave him 24 hours to present an accredited diploma, or he would need to take the GED.
It was a little degrading, I have to be honest. It was a little disheartening. I was like, well, I kind of proved myself that I've gotten a 4.0 in two of your classes, and you're making me take a general equivalency test that's for dropouts.
After failing to hand over a diploma, school officials pulled Jacob out of class and booted him from the school.
It kind of felt like a freight train hit me at that day, and it was really kind of a feeling, kind of my heart dropped out of my chest, like, what am I going to do now?
His parents, who homeschooled Jacob and his older brother without any problems, were shocked.
I didn't ever expect to come up against something like this. You know, I just assumed other homeschoolers have blazed the trail and taken care of that. And initially, I was taken back a little.
Obviously, there was a little bit of outrage. This isn't right. They didn't give him an explanation, really, except that he needed a diploma that was certified.
CBN News spoke by phone with college president Sharon Stevens. While she declined our request for an interview, she called what happened with Jacob an unfortunate but innocent mistake. She pointed out that federal funding regulations can be difficult to understand. She sees what happened as a much-needed lesson.
I sent a letter to the college president, and I do this all the time.
Mike Donnelly of the Homeschool Legal Defense Association says homeschoolers in West Virginia self-certify completion of a home education in compliance with federal funding guidelines, so they don't need an accredited diploma.
Jacob has been reinstated here at West Virginia Junior College, but some say what happened here is just one example of the growing pressures faced by homeschoolers across the country.
The college president called Jacob Berry and said that he could come back to school. So it's a great success story, but it shouldn't ever happen.
Unfortunately, it appears regulations for homeschooling vary from state to state and district to district. In Hampton, Virginia, families who homeschool for religious reasons must file a religious exemption. It requires the children provide a notarized philosophical and theological argument about their beliefs.
This whole idea that children, separate from their parents, should get a notarized form saying what their religious beliefs are is simply wrong.
Homeschool advocates want legislation that provides protection from such actions. Back in West Virginia, Delegate Brian Kirchaba sponsored a new law that prohibits any future cases similar to Jacob Berry's.
This came up right in the middle of everything, and fortunately, we were able to pass that legislation. Now the families can offer the diploma.
Absolutely fantastic. And the legislation also says that no state agency and no state institution of higher learning may discriminate, and it says treat anyone differently on the basis of their diploma. So that law would have helped Jacob Berry, but it will also make things much easier for homeschooled students in West Virginia.
Jacob's parents agree that the school's president was just misinformed about federal guidelines and hopes the takeaway from Jacob's story reaches beyond their state.
Maybe it will have an effect on other states and other situations that see the unfairness of the situation for Jacob, and it'll have a positive impact on for homeschoolers throughout the country.
As for Jacob, he's happy to be back and is looking forward to graduation in May of 2016. Charlene Aaron, CBN News, Fairmont, West Virginia.